Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. Saraswat, the Guest of Honor, Shri Rakesh Bakshi, Director of the Institute, Dr. Satish Kumar, members of the Senate, degree recipients, faculty and staff of the Institute, the media, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me an immense pleasure to preside over the 14th convocation of this Institute. As the head of the NITK family, I extend a warm personal welcome to Dr. Saraswat and Shri Bakshi and express our gratitude for accepting our invitation to grace this occasion with their presence. I congratulate both of them on receiving the honorary degrees which they richly deserve. It is an honor for the Institute to have had the opportunity of recognizing two such accomplished engineering professionals who have distinguished themselves in advancing technology in two fields that are critical to the country. Although this Institute has been in existence for over 50 years, every time a batch graduates, it is both a special occasion and a proud occasion. It is a special occasion because the Institute is bearing witness to yet another batch having successfully completed their professional studies, existing its portals, carrying its name, and spanning out to all corners of the country and the world. It is a proud occasion as these graduates, with the technical education that they have received in the Institute, are entering a field that is related to generating and applying technology, which is at the core of India's development agenda. As is often said, engineers are builders of the nation, both literally and figuratively. I congratulate the administration, the faculty and the staff who have all contributed to training and nurturing this batch and offering them in the service of the nation. To the graduates, I wish to say that you should savor this moment. This is the fruit of your labor and the result of the blessings of your parents and your teachers. This Institute, your alma mater, should always have a place in your heart. It is an Institute that has a long history of over 50 years and carries with it a rich legacy. Therefore, I call upon you to take on the responsibility of being ambassadors of this Institute and ensure that its flag is kept flying high with your committed performance in the field of your employment. Dear graduates, you belong to an elite group of young Indians who have been fortunate to have received a highly subsidized technical education. You should therefore be grateful to the society and the country for partly funding your education. To repay that debt should always remain a burden on your mind and drive your thinking and your actions. Each one of you should constantly be exploring ways and means of making a unique contribution, preferably a technology breakthrough which would advance the cause of the country's development. For that, first and foremost, love your country and be proud of its achievements. Rather than, as is the habit with many youngsters these days, forever harping on the country's shortcomings and failures. For example, we have three recent achievements in the field of science and technology that we can all be proud of. Number one, India has indigenously developed a variety of missiles that has given us capabilities available only to a limited number of countries in the world. Recently, India's test fired Agni-5 with a range of over 5,000 kilometers, which makes it possible for us to reach distant targets. DRDO and our chief guest here today, Dr. Saraswat, who was one of the architects of the program, should be applauded for this achievement in the field of missile technology. ISRO, using its workhorse, the PSLV, recently undertook a mega launch where it dropped off in space, not one, two or three, but a record number of 104 satellites in a single mission. Till now, Russia held the record of launching 37 satellites in a single mission. We bettered the record by a whopping 2.5 times. That's not all. Only 3 of the 104 satellites belonged to India. 101 were from other countries, 96 of which were from the USA. There was a time when we used to go to the US to get our satellites launched. Today, they come to us because we do it better and cheaper. What an achievement in space technology for India. Just a few days back, a newspaper, number three, just a few days back, a newspaper headline read, "A green future awaits India." This relates to the country's renewable energy push. Solar and wind energy have become the cheapest they have ever been in India, thanks to the low tariff achieved in two separate auctions recently. Solar energy was quoted as low as 2.97 unit per rupee per unit, and wind energy at 3.46 per unit. This is a historical development, and it shows the country's commitment to leverage two abundantly available alternate energy sources. The renewable energy sector, including Shri Rakesh Bakshi, who is a pioneer in the field of wind energy, deserves the country's gratitude. So these recent technological developments in the country should inspire young engineers like you, not only to celebrate our achievement, but also to strive towards making your own path-breaking contribution in the field of technology. I wish someday at least few months you will rise to a level of accomplishment when the institute will be happy and proud to invite you over to the role models to your younger generation, as we have done today in the case of Shri Rakesh Bakshi. I congratulate all the degree recipients and medal winners and wish them success and happiness in their professional and personal lives. I also congratulate the director of the institute and his team for organizing a very successful convocation. Thank you. God bless.